Today I'd like to talk to you about post-traumatic stress and some safe and very effective treatment options, including medical cannabis, which has recently been approved by the state of Maine to treat post-traumatic stress disorder. I personally understand the debilitating and limiting effects of post-traumatic stress. Perhaps you have lived through a traumatic event or witnessed one. If you haven't, the chances are one of your family or friends has. You may have noticed that the late effects of trauma can be extremely debilitating and limiting in people's lives, maybe your own. I'd like to tell you what has allowed hundreds of patients to say to me, "I finally feel like myself again. I finally have my life back." While some people's healing system can help them quickly recover from the effects of trauma, other people have prolonged symptoms. These symptoms are often placed into three categories: hyperarousal symptoms, where someone's easily frightened, always on edge, having trouble sleeping, having trouble concentrating; avoidance symptoms, where a person's life gets smaller and smaller, where they stop going out and stop facing reminders of the old trauma. There's also re-experiencing symptoms, where patients relive the trauma through flashbacks and nightmares, or actually feel the physical pain of the trauma as if it's happening right now. If these symptoms last more than a month and become limiting in a person's function in their life, that person may be diagnosed with post-traumatic stress disorder. There are many factors that can predispose a patient to developing post-traumatic stress disorder, and there are some excellent and safe treatments available for helping relieve these symptoms, for actually healing the condition and getting back to your life. I'd like to tell you about these treatments and first give you a little background information about your nervous system. We all have an autonomic nervous system. This controls our breathing, our circulation, our digestion, all the things that you don't have to think about. The autonomic nervous system has two branches. One promotes a fight or flight physiology, the other promotes a rest and digest physiology. When the fight or flight nervous system is activated, blood goes away from the digestion into the muscles so that we can react quickly, run away, get away, or defend ourselves. The brain also changes, and we become less able to think rationally or clearly. We become one-tracked and have very fast and strong emotional responses to our environment. While all of these changes may have helped our ancestors avoid predators like a tiger attacking, they're not that useful for modern stressors, and we certainly don't want to live in that state of our nervous system day in and day out. Patients who experience post-traumatic stress seem to be stuck in that part of their nervous system. They're stuck in the fight or flight mode. It's almost as if the trauma is literally locked inside their body, and until they release it, they're not going to be able to relax and find balance mentally and physically in their lives. In that state, patients experience chronic pain, poor digestive health, trouble sleeping, trouble maintaining healthy relationships with their families and loved ones. They seem always to be on edge, always in fear of what might happen next. In my practice, the goal of treatment for post-traumatic stress is twofold. First of all, we need to help patients relieve these symptoms so they can get back to their life, so they can start feeling a little normal again, to help them sleep, to help them digest their food, to help them relax. We need something that's going to work quickly and effectively. On the other hand, we also need to address the cause of the post-traumatic stress and help release the stored trauma from the body so that they can truly get back to a state of health. I've been incredibly impressed by both the relief of suffering and the true healing that patients have experienced when using medical cannabis to treat post-traumatic stress. It helps with almost all of the negative symptoms of post-traumatic stress. It promotes sleep, it helps patients relax, it brings patients into the present moment and enables them to stop thinking over and over again about those old traumatic memories or the old feelings of trauma, even the pain from trauma. All of those symptoms diminish when using cannabis. Cannabis also has been shown to be effective for releasing this stored trauma from the body. Scientists call this fear extinction, and there's been a number of animal studies that have proven that the compounds found in cannabis will actually promote fear extinction help animals release the trauma and return to their normal functioning. And recently, there's been two human studies, placebo-controlled trials, that have used two of the most common and therapeutic substances in cannabis, THC and CBD. And both of these trials showed that the cannabinoids enhanced the effectiveness of other fear extinction therapies. This means that if you're using medical cannabis to treat PTSD, you're not only going to get great relief and be able to quickly return to an improved level of functioning in your life, but you're actually more likely to heal at a deep level. You're more likely to release this old trauma and actually become yourself again, actually feel normal again. There are many effective therapies that facilitate release of stored trauma or fear extinction. Treatments like traditional psychotherapy can be effective. In my practice, I've seen even more powerful results from treatments like EMDR, an eye movement technique, EFT, which is emotional freedom technique, cognitive behavioral therapy, or CBT, and dialectical behavioral therapy, DBT. If you have access to these treatments, that's wonderful. They can really help you. And if you use cannabis in conjunction with these treatments, it's likely you're going to supercharge your results. On the other hand, life is therapy. We're constantly exposed to reminders and prompts that will bring these feelings up in us and help us process the old trauma. Again, if you're using cannabis to treat PTSD, you're likely to feel better and you're more likely to respond to these reminders from your life that will actually help you get better, that will help you process those old feelings, release them, and move on. Some patients are concerned about using cannabis to treat post-traumatic stress. We've been told that cannabis is addicting, that it's a gateway drug to other harmful substances, and that it kills brain cells. I must agree, there are some side effects from cannabis, but nothing like we've been told. Cannabis is about as addicting as caffeine. And while there are withdrawal symptoms from discontinuing cannabis after long-term use, they're very mild and well-tolerated. The side effects of cannabis are also very mild and can usually be eliminated by fine-tuning the treatment. The old saying that cannabis kills brain cells is completely untrue, and a lot of scientific research has actually shown that cannabis promotes the growth of new brain cells and helps us make new connections in our brain, which facilitate new patterns of thought and new behavioral responses to our environment. Finally, cannabis is much safer than the conventionally recommended treatments for post-traumatic stress. There's no lethal overdose of cannabis. It's not associated with an increased risk of suicide, like the first-line treatment for post-traumatic stress in conventional medicine is. There's no dangerous withdrawal effects. It's generally well-tolerated. And many patients can use a very small amount of cannabis to get great results. I also hear some concerns from patients that they'd like to use cannabis to treat post-traumatic stress, but they don't want to be high or stoned all the time. Well, you don't have to be, and you can still get great results. There are strains of cannabis that are high in CBD or cannabidiol, and these strains don't invoke the intoxication that most people associate with cannabis use. There's also delivery systems that make it so you don't need to smoke cannabis. You can use a vaporizer, a liquid extract called a tincture, capsules, edibles. There's many forms of cannabis that can be fine-tuned to fit you, to help you relieve your symptoms, to promote your healing, and to find balance in your life. If you or a loved one is suffering from post-traumatic stress, please call the office and set up an appointment with one of our compassionate and caring providers. We'll take the time to get to know you, and we'll do whatever it takes to help you navigate this very complex and sometimes confusing world of medical cannabis. We'll help you understand how to find the right strain, the right delivery system, the right dosage, and how to integrate your cannabis use with other health-promoting therapies. We will be in your corner for the long haul. We'll do whatever it takes to see you through this challenging time, to help you get past that trauma and return to who you really are.